Hi, so I'm Hamish and I study maths at Queen's. So why did I choose Queen's? So I've got to admit I was a little bit lucky really, as I didn't do that much college research before applying, but it turns out that Queen's suited everything I would really want in a college. It's a beautiful central college in the middle of the city and offers accommodation for all the years of your degree. What you might not know is that every college has a specific target region in the UK, and I'm from Cumbria in the northwest, which is one of Queen's target areas. So when there was a university open day, they invited students from schools in Cumbria to stay in the college to make the travel a bit easier. And having been here, when I realised I had to pick a college, I saw no reason not to choose Queen's. The food was great, the people were lovely, and the room I stayed in was really comfortable, so I was sold already. My favourite bit of the college has to be the library. It really makes me proud of Queen's. It's absolutely stunning and it makes studying there much more enjoyable. I think it's a really important feature of a college, as many students do the majority of their academic work in their library. So if you don't really like studying there, or it's not a very nice place to be, then you're going to struggle because you'll have to go out of college to find other libraries. Queen's has recently had an extension to their library as well, which means there's a lot more space, and there's a part of, like, a modern section which is much more open and much more bright if you're a bit intimidated by the old-fashioned parts of the library. So maths is quite an intense course, particularly in first and second years. You start with around 10-hour-long lectures a week in the department, which is an amazing modern building about 15 minutes walk from Queen's. You also have problem sheets to complete for each of your modules every week, and you'll have a tutorial on these each week with your tutor in college. These tutorials will usually be with one or two of the students, which means it's a great opportunity to really tailor the session to what you are struggling with on the course. As you get older and going to the later years, the modules you do become more specialised, so less people will take them and less tutors will know about them. So you have more work in terms of it's harder, but less work overall in terms of deadlines. So I think in my later years, I would only have six lectures a week and two classes a week, so, and there'd be more students in those classes. Interviews was a really great experience for me. It was the moment I really wanted to get an offer to study at Oxford. I think before that, I'd very much had a it's worth a shot attitude. And once I got back from interviews, I was much more like, now it's the be all and end all, now I really want to get in. It was so much fun, it gave me a glimpse of how happy I'd be at Queen's. I met loads of other applicants and some students, and it really made me think, yeah, this is somewhere I'd like to be studying. The interviews themselves were tough and obviously a lot more like a maths class, well, interrogation than an interview, I guess. It was sort of one long question that just seemed to have an extension every single time you finished, so you didn't really know how well you'd done compared to other people because you didn't get on to a second question ever. In terms of preparation, I was told that mainly tutors are looking at aptitude and see how you think rather than what you know, so I didn't do so much in terms of that. I did manage to find one person who gave me a mock interview, but it was nothing like the interviews I actually had. I think the tutors are really trying to see what you'd like, what you'd be like in a tutorial situation, so they're looking to see how quickly you learn new concepts. So it's less about what you know and more about how what's your aptitude like. Queen's is definitely its own little community. Even if you don't know everyone on a first name basis, there's a real sense of camaraderie and unity in the college. I think most people meet some of their best friends at Queen's, although that's probably true for a lot of the colleges too. Queen's has lots of sports teams to get involved with too, so if you really like sport, but even you're not very good, so I'm not very good at football or rugby, but if you want to play, you'll be welcomed regardless of your skill level. I tried to get involved in quite a lot of things outside my degree, trying to break the stereotype of mathematicians that do nothing but maths. I play several sports for the college, as I mentioned, football and basketball and rugby. There's lots of things you can get involved with. But I also play corfball for the university, which is a sport I picked up from scratch. I didn't know anything about it. Although it is quite similar to basketball and netball, which I had played before. I think it's great how many clubs and societies there are to get involved with, particularly if you're open to trying something new. And corfball has now become a highlight of my week with regular matches and socials as well as the training side, so it's kind of an opportunity to meet new people outside of the college as well. I also started a band this year, which was surprisingly easy to do as well, just by reaching out on social media to other musicians around the university. So I've met new people through that as well, and getting to do performances and gigs like that is another thing that kind of is interesting to me to do outside of my degree. So I've now brought several friends to the college and they're always really, really impressed. Like, their first comment is always like, oh, you study at Hogwarts, like, look at this building, it's crazy. I always try and take them to the dining hall as well, so to a college formal, which we have each weekend. And they're always, it's very funny seeing their faces when you, then someone stands up and says grace in Latin, and they're just completely shocked by this, because that's so far from where my friends all come from, and obviously where I come from in the north, it's not something that they've ever kind of experienced up here. After that, I show them the library, because obviously I've said that that's one of my favourite parts of the college. But then following that, we usually go down to the college bar, which is their favourite part, but that's mainly because I have to pay for the drinks.